Thank you, everyone. Thank you, everyone. I got a green light, no volume. Thank you, everyone, and welcome to the Special Governance and Priorities Committee meeting of Thursday, October 11th. We have before us a presentation on a draft corporate strategic plan, and then going in camera to discuss our proposed budget reduction strategies, recognizing that maybe legal or personnel implications. I am looking for a motion to approve the agenda.
So moved.
All those in favor? Opposed? Thank you. First one is the adoption of minutes. Any issue, moved by Alto, any issues, corrections? So the motion is on the table, it is now looked for corrections. Alto.
On page 8, under the action item with regard to initiative number 20, I believe, according to my notes, that there was an amendment made to number 2, deleting the references, the words outlined in the memo dated September 21st, 2012. And that in the bullet point, my notes said starting 2013 through 2014. I'm fairly certain that we made that amendment because we didn't want to be looking just at what was in the excellent memo that was provided by staff. We wanted to have a larger...
Thank you. Councillor? Isaac, is it directly
related? It is. I would concur 100%. I was actually going to propose the same correction. And I think the idea was it's a great memo, but if we were to adopt it as worded in our minutes here, it would preclude any discussion of nudging and technologies.
We're not here to discuss why. We're just here to alter the minutes.
So, no, I concur 100% with Councillor Alto's recollection.
Outlined in the memo dated September 8th, starting 2013
through 2014.
And ending 2014.
Through 2014.
And through 2014. Everybody got that?
Yes. Yes.
Oh, okay.
Yes. So in number 2, it should just read implement further open data slash open data, open government slash open data measures, period. And then the bullet underneath says starting 2013 through 2014.
And Mr. Woodland, I believe, was beckoning for you, Your Worship.
Mr. Woodland.
There will be some vagueness in that. You won't understand what you want us to deal with and what you don't. There's a lot of initiatives. So I just put that out there as it would be helpful for staff for it to be grounded in something somewhere because of the breadth of those initiatives and the other issues that so I know this motion came from the floor. If we recorded it incorrectly, that's fine. But we would ask that somewhere, sometime, it gets grounded in something specific. Otherwise, there will be great uncertainty as to what the council is intending.
Great.
Councillor Alto?
I think that was part of our discussion last time when we did make that amendment. But I'm certain that in the discussion, there was an expectation that very shortly, there would be some more detailed proposal, perhaps based on the memo that was provided, that would provide some direction to staff. In the alternative, you could simply say as generally outlined. But the point of the discussion last time was, as Councillor Isaac suggested, was not to confine just to the memo. So in our zeal, perhaps last time, we perhaps oversimplified and just deleted where perhaps we might have perhaps as a starting point or in general.
Okay, so thank you very much. That's great. We have the intention. We will look for Mr. Woodland to bring something forward that will help clarify direction for staff. But in correction in minutes, this reflects, the correction reflects what was discussed. So we leave it with that. It's not about adding stuff, amending it, wishing we had said more things, but that sort of stuff. It's about having accurate minutes. Councillor Isaac.
Yeah, but to respond to Mr. Woodland's concern, I think the memo as outlined for me is more than satisfactory to provide council with a basis for discussion. So even submitting that memo to GPC, I think, would give us the opportunity to provide that direction.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. And I believe Mr. Woodland is bringing that memo for budget implications.
Excellent.
For the minutes, I need everyone to vote and approve a lot of that amendment. Vic, Hope, Gary, thank you. Any other amendments? Seeing none, I would look for a approval of all of those in favor. Opposed, carried. All of those did already. Thank you. Excellent. Presentation. Council, we have a draft strategic plan in front of us. Part of reflecting, I hope, your intention, the council's intention, was meeting with the staff and saying that the intention is to provide a draft here that we are to massage, not to bring something in and say, this is exactly what we want. So the intention, so staff, if they didn't get it right, it was because it wasn't their intention to get it absolutely right. They didn't want to usurp council's role of changing it, making sure it reflects those sort of things. So I just wanted to do that highlight of I didn't want them to do so much work and have that nice, beautiful print balancing that this is our intention for doing that. So they are going to welcome our suggestions, but don't hold them for saying you got this wrong because it wasn't their intention for them to have that high level, that highest of level. Thank you. Welcome, Janice.
Thank you. City manager will.
Thank you, Gail's moving forward. Got it.
Anyway, thank you, through your worship. I'm really pleased to present the 2013 to the 2015 strategic plan for your consideration today. As you're aware, this was the culmination of many, many council discussions, input from some of the directors, and we're really pleased to have this draft plan with some direction and deliverables to guide the work of the staff for the next 3 years. Strategic plans are obviously very important because they outline your priorities, and they're also a tool by which we can measure our progress and the accountability to you and communicate any results we have. They're also, I think, the catalyst of council and staff to have regular discussions about what we said we'd do, you know, where are we, what are the most important strategies for the organization. And as we culled through all of the notes that were taken during your meetings, there were clearly four priority areas that were identified. It was clear from discussions with council that we would be focusing on fiscal sustainability and growing the economy. It was clear we must continue our focus on improving customer service as a necessary foundation for supporting a strong economy, and a clear commitment to supporting informed and open decision making. And so the strategies and key initiatives align with these priorities, and staff are keen to align their work plans and detailed action plans so that we can support all of the priorities council has chosen. For each of these initiatives that we've identified here, we will report quarterly on our update, similar to what we've done in the past, with kind of a very quick look of whether we're red light, green light, yellow light, and explanations. I also want to take this opportunity to sincerely thank staff. It's been a tremendous amount of work to pull it together, and they've been working really hard to capture all of the things that have been brought forward. As the mayor said, we're quite anxious to get any feedback from you. We do want the final plan to reflect your priorities and your direction for the coming years. I'm going to turn it over to Janice. She's going to go through a little bit of an overview of the development process and how everything fit and what the structure of the plan is, and then I'll highlight some of the key areas.
So Janice, I'm going to ask you to go through this. Council, make notes on the side, all that sort of stuff, but we'll get you through and then we'll come back and clean up.
Sure, that would be great, thank you. I just want to take a few minutes to orient you to the context and the structure that we've provided here and the approach so that you've got context for this presentation, but also for the rest of the plan. And the city manager will walk you through each of the elements and discuss that. There's a figure in your plan under the heading of working together to achieve our goals. And this diagram shows that, just illustrates how the plan is an ongoing collaboration between council, staff, and the community. And it shows the individual and collective roles that we all play in achieving our goals. As everybody at this table knows, council has been engaged in planning and priority sessions now since about April. And we started off in those early meetings with council discussing their vision, mission, values, and goals. And those form the framework for the remainder of the plan. Once we had those established, then we focused on what actions or initiatives can we possibly achieve over the next 3 years to make our vision become a reality. while staff are reviewing the capacity of the organization to deliver on those recommended initiatives, as Gail mentioned, a number of themes began to emerge whereby we could take those priority initiatives and look at them in clusters of larger groupings, and that's where those four priorities came from. And those concepts, we think, also reflect discussions that council has had over the past several months, and we think those kind of describe the intent that we would have, but certainly if there are other views there, we're potentially looking at that. We then looked at strategies and initiatives that would enable those priorities and what our ability was to accomplish those. Once we had determined those, the staff looked at some development performance indicators. We worked with all of the departments, different directors and staff to come up with indicators that we thought were meaningful in measuring our progress and achieving our goals, but also were within our ability to actually measure reliably over time. So we wanted to make sure we could deliver on all of those items. Because each component of the plan builds on and informs the previous component, we think that the result is a comprehensive and cohesive plan that has linkages that can be seen between the priorities, the goals, the strategies, the initiatives, and the measures. It's meant to have that kind of cascading hierarchical look to it. The actual components of the plan and the content are based around these elements. A lot of this content will be familiar to you because we've reviewed it and discussed it before, but there are some new things that you haven't seen or haven't seen quite in the same format before. So just working through the plan that you have in front of you, it starts off with some introductory messages from the mayor and the city manager, and these summarize some of the key influences and the factors that shape the development of the plan overall. The next sections, pages 8 through 15, lay out the mission, vision, the values, and the service principle. And these are the areas that we previously discussed and have provided feedback on this as well. What you'll also notice is, as requested, we've added some little descriptive preambles to each of those sections to provide a bit more context and embellish a bit more on what the intent of those sections is. The next section of the document describes the tangible actions that will occur between 2013 and 2015. What you'll notice is that this plan is quite a bit more focused than previous plans that we've had, and that's because of our limited financial resources. We really saw there was a need to focus in and be very clear on what was achievable and what we could do, all with the view to achieving the highest level goals and the priorities that council has set. So everything links back and leads back to those factors. Initiatives that were planned for this period, as we've discussed before, were also limited to those which we know are feasible to do within our financial ability, but also that counted the largest contribution to the achievement of our goals and priorities. On page 17, we just confirmed the four strategic areas of the plan, and these are similar, the same as we had in the previous plan, actually, and we've discussed these as well, and we felt that was still a good structure for organizing the content of the plan to focus on their four areas. Page 21 is new. You won't have seen the priorities in this fashion before, but these are the four categories that Gail described earlier that were drawn from previous council discussions and reflect these overarching priorities. The next several pages align the goals formulated by council during the planning and priority sessions, the strategies and the key initiatives. And the goals that we've got in the plan are a reflection of the end state. They're considered end state goals, so they look at what the results are we're looking for, or the desired end state that we're trying to go for. Once we have that information from council, then staff are able to go back and look at the initiatives that have been discussed and approved on the 20th of September, as well as the goals and the values, and structure strategies that link the two together. So the strategies as well will align with all of these other, all of the other factors. In previous versions of strategic plans, we've had objectives as well as strategies. And we thought to make the plan more readable and maybe a bit crisper, we've structured the strategies in such a way that they actually encompass the kinds of things you put in objectives so that it's clear what your primary action is going to be to achieve your objectives and then what it is you're actually trying to achieve. We thought that made the strategies a bit more meaningful. So we've made that sort of a change. And then lastly, the key initiatives, which you have seen before. Not every key initiative is reflected in this plan. We chose the strategic initiatives that are most appropriately documented and documented of this sort. Some of the more operational type initiatives, like finalizing agreement with Fortis BC, for example, is something that's very operational map that doesn't necessarily need to be in our strategic plan. But you can be assured that all of those initiatives on the priorities and the must-do lists are in the action plans and the work plans of staff, even though they're not appear here. And some of them have been reworded a little bit differently to add greater clarity and provide maybe a greater sense of the intent of those. One of the examples of an open data, open government, as Councillor Altman and Isaac spoke to earlier, we had to make that a little bit broader to reflect what your intent might be over the 3-year period. And lastly, we concluded a set of performance indicators and some targets. And we outline in the plan how we will measure our performance in meeting the goals in the plan. And we will have regular reports to you on initiatives, but also we will be reporting annually as we're required to public and to council through our annual report on the progress we've made on these measures. And these aren't the only indicators and performance measures that the city is tracking and reporting on. There are many other things that we want to report on publicly as well that we do every year in our annual report. But these really are the foundation of the strategic side of that. So hopefully that orients you a little bit to the approach that we took in taking all the information that has been gathered over the last months and then collected together in a plan. How all of these pieces now come to life in the plan will be reviewed with you by the city manager.
Thank you very much, Janice. The first part of the plan really talks about sort of things that are long-term in nature, vision, mission, values, and service principles. And our vision is the picture of the future we want to create. Where would we like to be? And the vision is Victoria is a vibrant, richly diverse, and sustainable city built upon our heritage and our unique lifestyle. While the strategies to achieve this goal are set up in the plan, they may change over time, but the overall vision set up in the plan is considered long-term. And I think we also had, through the OCP, 6,000 people did feedback, and we actually wrote in words, taking all of that feedback together that you saw in the previous plan that's also in this plan that describes what Victoria would look like in 2030 if all of our aspirations for the city came true. Our mission describes our function and our purpose and what we do, how we do it, and where we do it. And our mission is twofold: to make the city of Victoria a leader in social, economic, and environmental sustainability, and to deliver quality services that are critical to the well-being and the quality of life of Victorians. Our values reflect the kind of community and the kind of corporate environment we hope to create for the city. The values are respect, integrity, openness, collaboration, inclusivity, and compassion. Our service principles will guide our daily activities of staff and result in high quality service delivery. They underline our commitment to excellence in public service. We want to be future oriented, we want to be open, accountable, and we want to be responsive. We want to embrace continuous improvement and for sure offer value for money. The four strategic areas are similar to the last, where we talk about our city government, focuses on council decision making and the organization's performance. Our community concentrates on issues of livability and social well-being for the community and its citizens. Our economy focuses on what is needed to encourage economic growth and vitality. And our environment targets our ability to protect and sustain the natural and the built environment and reduce our ecological impact. We've looked at the four priorities areas I mentioned before, and under each one of these are a variety of initiatives that I won't go into detail with. Many of them you are quite familiar with. In fact, some of them actually have their own strategic plan, like the economic development plan and the customer service plan. So underneath each of these four themes, there are a whole variety of initiatives that the city will spend some time making sure we have detailed action plans. The majority and the larger projects under the strategic initiatives will also come back to you in the form of charters, so that you can see what the performance will be, the milestones, who's the lead department, and what you can expect at the end of the project. So, as an being able to report back to you in the first quarter in 2013 with some real progress against the priorities you've set for us. And with that, I will turn it over to any questions that you may have.
Thank you very much. And I'm going to start it, and then we'll pick up with councillors. The first thing, councillors, for me, which I wanted to put forward as under a priority for 2013 to 2015 and make a suggestion. I think that I'd like to add in a fifth category that reflects the work that we did within our priority setting. And the fifth category, and we can wordsmith it as we wish, enhance the quality of life of residents, foster more social sustainability, whoever the right term is. I think for me, and then within that, we pull out and address the issues that we picked as our priorities. The housing issue, the affordable housing, the public transportation, enhancing public transportation as part of it. The parks work that we need to do under Dallas Road and the transportation plan, the balustrade, the Beacon Hill, again, transportation plan, the bluffs, the work that we're going to have to do around Crystal Pool and our recreation facilities, the work around the parks and related to the Johnson Tree Bridge. For me, I believe that the city is more than just a balance sheet. And the priorities that we've left out here, that we put up there, are important, absolutely. Fiscal sustainability, grow the economy, enhance customer service. Those are important things. But the reason we do those, the purpose behind that, is so that we can continue to enhance the life of our residents. It is not just what is the bottom line and what is the balance sheet. The fiscal restraint that we can show, the fiscal finesse that we use is to allow us to pick and enhance those priorities that our citizens say are important. Parks, affordable housing, public transportation, those things that actually make the quality of life and make people that want to live in this city better. It's just not that my taxes are cheap. There are many examples of towns that are that way. So I think really it's what we picked as a priority, and I don't want to wordsmith it, that's part of what we want staff to do. But I think that I would suggest that we do have that fifth bullet that basically explains why we're doing this. And I think enhance the quality of life of residents is probably a good working title. And with under that, we would have pulled together those pieces. They're in there, but that's the thing that I would suggest we ask and put on that as one of those suggestions. Other than that, I have a small, move this bullet here, move that bullet there, but I'll wait to see if that sort of stuff. So with that, Janice, we'll see if council will support that as a good direction. We'll move from there. We now have Phelps and then Isaac.
I just have a process suggestion that we kind of attack the plan or approach it in two sections, pages 1 through 21, which is kind of the values piece, and pages 23 through 32, which is kind of the content piece, in a way of focusing our discussion. And then I have some comments, but does that work as a way of proceeding? Just so we can make changes to one section and then instead of each of us going through the whole plan.
Sure, it's a good, all roads to Jerusalem, or where we choose to go. I mean, if you have issues, so focus for now on 1 through 23, today 1 through 21, and pick up the priority section from there.
So just some quick comments. First of all, I feel so proud of this already, and it's not even done yet. So I just, that's wonderful, so thank you. And I also, the vision, I wrote wonderful and aspirational. So if we can make this kind of city together, I think that's wonderful. Just a few, and I guess this is our time to dig in and have a few quick suggestions. So on page 7, at the bottom, again, small things, but we're here to make this as perfect as we can. I would just suggest where we can save you a trip to City Hall. We will, just to be really clear, because we're oriented around City Hall, but not everybody else is.
Yeah.
I know what it was meant, but just to make it really clear. Okay, page 10.
I'm sorry, where were you?
Page 7, I was just adding something to Gail's statement. When we can save you a trip, we will, but I think it means when we can save you a trip to City Hall, we will.
Oh, okay.
But also recreation centers to register your...
Sure, to city facilities.
Facilities.
Something, just yeah. To, yeah. And page 10, reflecting on the really important document on page 21. We don't need to go there right now, but working together to achieve our goals. Sorry, on page 19. I would just suggest changing the mission. The intent is the same, but something like this, instead of we strive to provide the citizens, we strive to create with the citizens, residents, visitors, and businesses of the city of Victoria, a livable, vibrant city, and to provide services that enhance quality of life. Should I say that again?
Okay, so folks, as I said, if you violently disagree, let me know right away.
Yeah, good idea.
Otherwise, staff assume that everybody agrees, and then it can change its mind. So, if you violently disagree, thank you.
Do you want the other side in support of it as well, or just...
No, if you're in some violently in support,
you have to do it. Okay. Cheering is allowed.
I don't disagree with it at all, but my mother would roll over her grave at the grammatical reconstruction of that sentence. So if you could say something like, you know, with working with our citizens, residents, visitors, and businesses, we strive to blah, blah, blah.
Yeah, to create a livable, vibrant city and to provide services.
Yeah.
I don't want to be enviable. I think that we shouldn't encourage jealousy. okay. And then one further thing on that page, and it would need, if there's no violent disagreement, it would need a similar correction on page 21. I would say deliver quality services that are essential to the well-being and quality of life of Victorians. I'm still on page 10, but there's the exact same sentence.
Yeah, essential's good.
Essential's good, and that goes with the mayor.
21, where are you?
Sorry, I'm on 10, and it would require...
Oh, okay, I thought you were skipping 21.
It's the same wording is in both places, so in order to prevent going to the same place, saying the same thing twice. I'm saying on page 21 and page 10.
21 and 1, 2, 3, or 4.
It's in the first sentence, number 1. To provide, all I'm suggesting is that we change the word critical to the word essential. Deliver quality services.
Yep. Everybody's happy with that? They all wildly agree.
Goes with the mayor's comment about everything else. Page 17. I would suggest in the very top sentence, with a strong strategic vision, the city is committed to making a positive difference in the daily lives of Victorians rather than a real difference.
Sorry, what did you say? I'm sorry, I couldn't hear.
Oh, page
17. Thank you.
To make a positive difference in the daily lives of Victorians. Rather than a real difference, we want to make a positive difference. We want to make it the best plan as possible, right? That's why we're at the table today. So,
real positive experience.
No, I'm just a positive. Strike real. We could make a real difference if people are really negative. Okay, page 19. And I'm sorry that this didn't strike me earlier because this document, this diagram, has been before us for a long time. But the first sentence reads, as shown in, first of all, the heading is working together to achieve our goals. And then it says in the first sentence, as shown in the figure below, council staff and the community work together. And every bubble has people doing things, except the community doesn't have anyone doing anything. So I would suggest if we really want to include the community that we create, and I'm open, obviously, to create two other bubbles in yellow above here, and one I would suggest provide operating revenue through property taxes, and the other bubble provide input through public engagement processes. Because those are kind of the two things that we expect of our residents, and so I would want that to be fleshed out in this diagram so it doesn't look like we do everything and the community actually doesn't do anything.
Looking at everybody around the table.
Can you repeat the first one?
Again, I'm not tied to the wording, but something in the spirit of provide operating revenue through property taxes, or just provide revenue through property.
Yeah, can you just limit to provide operating revenue?
Well, but they also provide capital revenue through the...
My only concern is that I don't want to eliminate the possibility of them providing revenue through other sources other than property taxes, right?
But
so there could be user fees, there could be investment programs.
Okay, sure, provide revenue... Sure.
Provide revenue
to the city? Okay, and then provide input through public engagement processes.
I always love how Councilor Young leans forward. Councilor Young.
Well, once we start down the road of trying to define the role of the community, there's no end to it. The community does a lot more things than sign their tax checks and sit on public community. I suggest that we not start down that road and maybe say something like council and staff works with the community to set all directions so that we're not trying to fully define the role
sure.
of the community. What we're doing is we're trying to define our role in working with the community.
Great, I agree. That makes it better. It just, we don't want to say we're working with the community and then we're all doing stuff and they're not doing anything. So
okay,
I'm.
Okay, so we'll look at changing, so it's more about changing the first sentence than adding it to the bottom.
Yep.
Thank you.
Part of the purpose,
did you capture that, Jen?
Yes, I did. Part of the purpose of this diagram, too, is to show how we can, how we are accountable. So we can hold councils and staff accountable for achieving what's in this
mm-hmm.
plan. We can't really
yeah.
hold the community accountable, but recognizing they have a role to play, we didn't want to exclude them because they do play an important part in terms of partnership, public engagement, that kind of thing.
That's
so
great.
That's
yeah.
Specifically
the kind of
change
that
line.
Well, specific, I think it's specifically to it. Because I don't know what it is, but it's to put in the encourage word. So for example, collaboration, we welcome and encourage our community. Like, I think it's one thing. So working together is encouraging people to participate in the process. That's all. I just think that that's an important element that we are encouraging the participation of the community.
I just have one point.
Okay, so folks, what I've just heard is we're not making any changes to that picture.
No, we are. We are to the wording, but not to the picture.
Not to the picture.
But are you, do you want to keep the same to make sure that encourage work and the fact that council slash community work together, which is encouraging?
I think,
I need to understand. Perhaps Councilor Gutton, can you explain this?
It sounds pretty hard.
Lisa's change.
Okay, Lisa's on two pages, so I'm on. Okay, I guess I'm all over the map because I just think encourage is lacking on page 12, but it works with that how we can implement. So with wordsmithing, I think the staff understands the point of what I'm trying to say. Under our values, which is maybe spinning ahead and out of Lisa's page, it's got collaboration. We welcome the opinions and expertise of our citizens, businesses, and partners. So if we're talking about the community, that's who they are. And I think encourage, so we welcome and encourage the opinions and expertise of our citizens, businesses, and partners. And I think that's a fundamental shift in the language to add encourage to it. And I think it needs to go somewhere in the working together to achieve our goals.
So, why don't
so it's an encouragement.
Why don't we restate that value right at the beginning? We welcome and encourage the opinions and expertise of our citizens, businesses, and partners.
So it's just adding encourage.
Yeah. Then you say council, staff, and community work together to set broad direction for the city and establish priorities.
Great. So moving that.
All they're doing is on page 12, we have a statement under collaboration. We welcome the opinions and expertise of our citizens, business, and partners. Do you want to restate that line at the beginning of this paragraph?
Beginning of page 19.
On page 19.
Okay. So adding encourage.
We welcome and encourage the opinions. Yeah.
Well, or we welcome opinions and encourage participation.
Great, that's better.
We welcome opinions and encourage participation. I don't know about the expertise, but I'm sure the staff.
You got it, Janet. Just work it for us.
Yes.
Perfect.
Okay. And
okay.
My final comment on the first section of the plan is on page 21. Again, it's just a clarification thing. Under number one, financial sustainability. In the fifth line down after 3.25%, it should say, I believe, the annual tax increase will remain at or below 3.25% per year. So we're not giving the impression that it's not going to go over that between 2013 through 15.
Well,
it says
the
annual.
Annual.
Yeah.
The annual tax increase.
Yeah. Yeah, okay. That's.
Okay, wait. Okay. Council, I want to go back and clean up 10. 10 or 12.
That's all for me.
Or at least do that. Mr. Woodland, I'd like us to go page by page and clean up each page before we bounce over the request. Mr. Woodland, what page is that first number that leads us?
Yeah, I was just suggesting that just to focus everyone's thoughts on the pages as we go through rather than hearing from one counselor and then jumping to another counselor who might have comments on that same page. Maybe we could just table any comments or discussion on page 10, for example, and then move on to another page that has comments.
Okay, so page 10, any other further comments on page 10, our mission? Councilor Isaac?
When will we be at page 1?
I'm gonna go page by page.
Okay, so after 10, okay.
So let me just, anything on page 1? No, I'm sorry, page 10.
Celebrating our history is problematic, and that comes from my professional expertise, the way I would listen quite strongly to Jeff's advice if we were looking at macroeconomics, or Pam's advice around how we treat heritage, or everyone's diverse experience at this table. That's one area where I do have pretty substantial professional background. History isn't something you celebrate, it's something you either recognize, or you acknowledge, or you respect, or you commemorate. And looking at the mayor's statements, I don't want to delve into further pages, but on his...
Stay on the cable contents.
Okay, but this year, we haven't only celebrated the history. Councillor Thornton-Joe brought forward the very important initiative where we actually rescinded a motion of this council from the 1940s calling for the internment of Japanese Canadians and the suspension of their civil liberties. So we've done a lot more than just celebrating Victoria's history, and that's appropriate. Yes, I would substitute the word, well, I'm open to the discussion. I'd throw out respecting. I think that helps to do with their treatment of heritage. The other ones could work, but I think that's the one that can still have a positive tone, but be respectful.
Does anybody violently disagree with changing celebrating our history to respecting our history?
Respecting implies some compliance. I think it's better to acknowledge the history and you can amend or change some of the things that you would like. So
sounds great.
I don't disagree with the intent, but I would...
Acknowledge sounds good to me. I was on the fence between those two.
Yeah.
And commemorate was a bit wordy, so that's
yeah.
Fine.
Good.
And so that would be a global change I'd recommend, or we can do it on each individual page. But maybe if staff could weigh in what their preference would be for...
Well, I think the issue what the staff wanted out of celebrating our history was trying to reflect what we have as our general overall mission and statement, which is that the piece that we had in there about recognizing that, what's our vision? Vibrant, rich, diverse, and sustainable city built upon heritage and lifestyle. So the goal is to celebrate the fact that our built heritage is part of what makes Victoria's unique. So to a certain extent, if we say recognize our, what was the question?
Acknowledge.
I think
the difference.
The difference. I know what you're saying. One is history and one is heritage. There's a difference.
Right. So we acknowledge that we've done a fabulous job of protecting some of our heritage buildings downtown, but we also acknowledge that in the 60s, we ripped apart one neighborhood and lost some heritage buildings to run a
freeway.
Auto-centered freeway.
Okay, guys, we're really getting bad here.
If there's no violent disagreement, then.
So, direct with Councilor Bell.
My only thought is that acknowledging doesn't mean any action necessarily. Yeah. It's very passive to me. It can be very passive, and that's my concern. You can acknowledge there's a great building, you can also knock it down tomorrow. Same thing with our actual history in terms of the actions that we created. So we can work with ever, but there's always going to be implications, regardless of the word.
So thank you for any new voices.
I don't disagree with the sentiment, but for me, what's missing in acknowledge is exactly what's there in celebrating. It's a positive, exciting, rewarding notion that something's good. If I acknowledge something, I'm just noting that it exists. But it doesn't indicate to me whether what I think about it. And so celebration for me has an aura of being positive. And I actually thought that the concern with celebration was going to go to a completely different tactic around the fairly complete omission of any reference to our First Nations people. So that's kind of where I was expecting. So I don't actually mind celebrating there, and I'm concerned with acknowledgement because it's just, it doesn't tell me anything. It doesn't say anything. It doesn't have a value statement. Maybe it shouldn't at this point, but I don't think it's good enough.
If it's helpful to council, just to remind you what this was a tagline that was created to kind of help to brand the plan and some of the sentiment about the vision, et cetera. It's not something that has to be part of the plan. It was something we put on as the last plan that we carried forward to this one. It was just meant to kind of tag the plan and add a little interest. So if there's concerns about that language or about having that tagline, that language, that line doesn't need to be there at all in that fashion. Something
integral element of a strategic plan, in other words. Yeah. I think it stands up more to me now that we're having a discussion. And there's, when I think of the history, I think of the built form, but I don't think there's a strong enough sense of people that build our city. And I think if you look at acknowledge and celebrate, when I think of the Chinese community, you know, we acknowledge that Chinatown exists because of the discrimination of the day. Mm-hmm. But we celebrate the fact that culture is still rich and vibrant and continue to thrive. The community has contributed to overall, you know, city. So I'm trying to think, how do we capture the essence of the people that built the city, you know, and all the people, whatever they contribute. So I'm not saying that, but meeting someone that's great at work is good to put that in the words.
I guess for me it is kind of coming like a council question, but I mean, in celebrating our history, you can say, okay, we have these laws of discrimination. Bad. Look, we've acknowledged it. Let's celebrate that we've looked at our history, and in the last year or 10 or whatever, that we've made these changes and recognized it. And we can celebrate the history of Victoria, that we acknowledged this stuff early, have dealt with it, and integrated it. So it's kind of one of those ones where, you know, you celebrate the good stuff, you acknowledge the bad stuff, and you move forward into the future. So, I love the fact that we can't get off the table of contents, but
well, I think I agree with what you just said. Could we not have acknowledge and celebrate together? Because it does both. Mm-hmm. It acknowledges our history and celebrate. It just add acknowledge to the line.
Acknowledge and celebrate our history. Thank you, Councillor Isaac.
I think as a wordsmithing change, that could make a lot of sentences in here cumbersome, and I think you really don't celebrate history. As someone who has a PhD in history, has taught the history of Victoria to young people, Pam can roll her eyes, but this is one area where I believe I have expertise. All my colleagues at UVic would agree. If you can find one historian in this city who thinks history should be celebrated, prove me wrong. Honestly, I think recognize is maybe a more proactive word, that you could recognize our history, but you don't celebrate it. It's just, you don't, because there's dark chapters in every community's history. So I feel pretty strongly about that one.
Thank you. I think we need to
I'll move that we strike out references to celebrate in this document and replace them with recognize.
Thank you. All those in support of that motion? 1, 2, 3, 4. Do that. Opposed? Did you give a vote or not? Pound your hand up.
Yes.
Thank you very much. Fails. A motion fails at that point. So that was Charlene, Chris, Pam, Dean, and Marianne.
So the knowledge is over.
It stays celebrator history.
Okay, so I thought you were taking out celebrate, but we weren't going to have
it. It was. Do you want to make a second motion?
So I move that we have acknowledged and celebrate.
Thank you. Motion on the table. All in favor? Opposed? Elves and eyes. Thank you. Anything else on table contents, folks? Nothing. Yay. anything on celebrating anything on page three? Young and then also.
I find the reference to the magazine survey of the largest thing is going to be lasting for more than a year. It seems a little temporary.
Mm-hmm. I agree.
So perhaps we just have
a big... Even if you wanted to say something generic like Victoria is recognized by...
Victoria is recognized as one of the top 10 cities in the Americas and hosts over 3.5 million visitors each year. Okay. Got that? Okay. So Victoria is recognized as one of the top 10 cities in the Americas and hosts over 3.5 million visitors. Good. Thank you, Marianne.
I'm not sure if this is the right page, but it's the only one that struck me, and that is... Going back to my earlier comment, there isn't anything very obvious in here for me around cultural diversity. And so there's no real specific references to First Nations people, or the list is endless. So I'm just wondering whether or not in that first paragraph on this page, it might be the best place, because I can't think of another one in any other pages. It says, on the third line down, Victoria's home to close to 83,000 culturally diverse people, or something, I don't know, I'm not sure where it goes or what the right language is, but this page seems to me to be the one that describes the people, mm-hmm. in a way, the population. And somehow, I think in here there has to be a reference to the diversity of the population, because otherwise it's pretty bland.
We can wordsmith that.
Yeah, so I'm not concerned about how you do it, but I think this is probably the best page for it.
Okay. With that, does anybody have any issues on page three?
Just for clarity, are we removing celebrating at the title and putting celebrating and recognizing?
All the way through.
Okay, so, okay, thanks.
Acknowledging and celebrating. Thank you, Councilor Hills.
Yeah, just one more thing following up on Councilor Alford's comments. We'll leave it to staff to word I would say 83,000 people of diverse backgrounds and home to the Songhees and Esquimalt peoples. Because we do have a very official relationship with them.
Traditional.
And
we're not home there.
Okay. Just to name the nations specifically, because there's cultural diversity of people who have come, and there's the people who were here when they came.
There you just listen.
Yeah.
Okay.
Then if you list two,
we'll make a broader statement that would be inclusive.
Yeah.
But we have a formal relationship where we recognize. Maybe that's where we need mm-hmm. to open it up.
Yeah,
we recognize that we are located on the
yes.
traditional
yeah, that's
territory. That's great. That's
perfect. Perfect. That's awesome.
That's the opening line on there.
Yeah, that's very good.
That's very good.
Okay.
And then the other
reference
background.
The cultural diversity yeah. in the text.
Got it.
Awesome.
Okay, thank you. Charlotte?
Okay.
Good. Everybody's happy with 3.1.2.1. Message from the mayor.
I'm not sure I'm happy with page 4. Just kidding.
Yeah, somebody like photoshopped all my hair up. Thank you. Okay, page 7. Lisa had one addition.
You've got that.
You've got that. Anybody else additions from message from? None. Great. Page 7's good now. Page 9.
Well, just to clarify, so Councillor Thornton Joe's motion was a global motion? Councillor Thornton Joe's acknowledgement is in
yep,
every room.
Done. Our mission, page 10. You got an addition to that, didn't we? Okay. All good. So
are we behind? Yeah, no, I was just seeing if they captured the original wording that Councillor Alto and I suggested.
Yes, I've got that.
Read it back.
She's got it. Janice, what do you got?
We had something along the line of working collaborative or working with our citizens, residents, and businesses to Victoria to create a livable, vibrant city and to provide services that,
yep.
et cetera, et cetera.
Yep. And then critical to essential.
Yes, critical to essential. And that's that last
one. We'll repeat that on page 21.
Perfect. Charlene, let's go.
Sorry,
go
ahead.
Okay,
table 9, page 9 on 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. and this is just a, you know, so my input. Topic this blank seems like a...
Line five or paragraph five?
First paragraph.
Thank you.
Something doesn't sit well. Mm-hmm. I feel it's official.
Mm-hmm.
Copy displaying Harper's mission's heritage. I have trouble with the word displaying.
Celebrating. How about acknowledging?
Yeah, acknowledging.
Yeah. I don't mind any of it, but I just find displaying.
Yeah. Proudly acknowledging.
I think acknowledging.
Yeah. Good one.
Okay. You're okay with that? Good. Thank you. Everybody's okay with 10? So you know my further changes to 10. Changes to 12. We're all happy with 12.
What was the change?
We have to change to the collaboration bullet.
Yeah.
Welcome and encourage.
Now, folks, I know this is dumb. Maybe it's just, then I want to check to see if it is dumb. On the picture on 13, give my kid hell if they go down head first.
Mm-hmm. Very good point. Special.
It was one of the ones I wasn't going to wordsmith anything on the little things or worry about the pictures because then you're a awesome picture. It was just as a parent, that one kind of struck me a little odd. And I totally love it because you get the smiling faces of the kids and blah, 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 blah. But
I just had
the rubber stuff on the bottom, so what? And you know, that little bit, you gotta break something once in a while, just to teach your kids about nice lesson. Okay, but I don't know, I just didn't know.
They're told they have to tie.
Is it worthwhile in terms
of they were told to stop, so the picture
can't be seen. Yeah. Seem to be finding this picture. And if you're
looking for another picture, I don't know.
No, just deal with this picture first. Oh, if you're looking for another one, okay, good.
I don't know whether we have any equipment in the city of Victoria that is accessible for people with disabilities.
With Victor Street.
Yeah, one of the things I noticed too, we don't have.
If that's not our park, Victor Street is.
True.
No, so if we do have.
Oh, you mean Victoria.
It might be a land.
But I'd love to show
Rob, why don't you go grab a great photo of Brandon Greenberg?
It actually is on city property and trust, according to the map in front of us.
Victor Street?
Yeah, is that the school? It is. It's one of the school board lands that's actually owned by the city.
Great credit for that. Okay, thank you. Okay. With that, so I wouldn't mind them. Sorry, I love the photo for a thousand reasons. The color of the kids, the whole stuff.
But you wouldn't put a picture.
I wouldn't put a picture of a kid riding a bike without a helmet.
No, I agree. I think it shouldn't be hard to find another high quality playground.
We all agree. Go find one. Thanks. Page 14, our service principles.
In response to both the districts, I'm sorry, phraseology.
Yeah, it's a little too colloquial.
Yeah.
We embrace innovation, we strive.
We strive.
We listen, we consider, we go the distance.
We'll find something.
Thanks. Thank you. Councilor Ryder?
I know several council members have raised the issue of customers and whether that's our primary raison d'etre as a government. So the opening line doesn't sit well with me. We exist to serve our valued customers. I think we exist to serve the people. Some of those people are residents and their capacity asking for a light bulb to be fixed. Some happen to be business operators. Others are volunteers. But customers is not our primary purpose here. I honestly think that is language. I just think the language to customer service here in later sections of the document, I think that's language from the private sector primarily that I think isn't the central purpose and the guiding value of public service. So just to throw it out there.
Thank you, Councillor.
I think where that is how it goes to say we exist to serve our life, I almost like the line say we take pride in public service. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. High quality service for our
citizens, businesses, and businesses.
Yeah, by leading on that.
That's great. Service.
But it can't be citizens because we have residents who are not citizens.
Yes.
So should be so businesses.
Residents, businesses, and visitors.
Yeah.
That's great. We take pride in public service.
And that just starts off.
We take pride in public service and the community ensure a high quality of service.
That's
for our residents, businesses, and visitors.
Great.
Moving on.
So, well, there is still, so customers comes repeatedly, and I don't know how we spend.
Let's deal with it as come forward.
Okay, so the third line in that same paragraph.
Oh,
gotcha. So we just move the residents
yes,
and businesses.
We just deleted the first line.
Sounds good.
Strategic direction, page 17.
We have the word conflict. Yep.
Everybody okay?
I know it's a semantic issue. I don't mind in the bubbles being our economy, our environment, our community. As it goes into the different targets, our environment targets, I think it's our ecological targets. We're going through a great discussion federally about whether we're trying to exercise scientific research. I would rather that we have our targets be ecological because they're scientifically based, rather than perhaps more passionate environment discussion. So I just like that change because I think it targets us more. So just change our ecological targets.
Environment
stays in the bubble. I have no problem. It's the one line.
Yeah, but the one line, okay, so what you really need to do is put community in dit-dits. I think there's a formal word for that. You put economy in that quotation marks, and you put environment, because it's referring to below. Our environment includes this. It refers to the bubble below.
That's correct.
Okay, so it's just a
different color.
You put in quotation marks.
Yeah.
Okay,
no. It's just
okay.
Yeah.
Anybody actually know? Moving forward, working together to achieve our goal. Thank you. Councillor Isaac, further on page 19.
I just want to follow up my earlier comment. I think customer service is appropriate here because it is one function, so I think it does make not a concession, it's just in staff's, I think, relationship with the public, there is an element there of how our parks workers conduct themselves, how we fix our light bulbs, what our development services desk looks like. So I think as a subset, it's a value that I can support, just not making it as our central.
So you're
mission.
Not suggesting any changes on this
not.
Page?
No.
Is anybody else suggesting any changes?
I actually agree with Councillor Helps earlier that I think this is good, but it's only a partial picture. I think this is the intersection of what we do with how we interact with the community. So I actually think we do need some work around the bubbles. I'm not sure I want to identify what the bubbles are, but there has to be some expression of community engagement.
Mm-hmm.
Councillor
Gudgeon. Thank you, Councillor
Ivey. Well, I would also say this might be the place, God forbid, to touch this one, that it's working with our neighbors in region and our neighboring region as a region working together to achieve our goals, because we cannot create a bus system independently without working with our neighboring municipalities. So whether there's the ability to add that we are proactively trying to engage our neighbors so that we can work together effectively. I don't know if there's agreement with the council table, but I think if the mayor wants to increase the transportation of our city, we cannot do it in isolation. If we're solving homelessness, we cannot do it in isolation. So it would show leadership on the city of Victoria to put that in our sort of Bible for the next 3 years, that we are going to start the conversation working together with our neighboring municipalities.
Councillor Rice?
I have a suggestion. I agree. I think the first sentence after priorities for action, so on the third line, we could put a comma, embracing regional partnership. 19, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. So as shown in the figure below, council, staff, and the community work together to set broad direction for the city and establish priorities for action. And we could add a comma, embracing regional partnerships where appropriate, period. Then we could create a new paragraph and have the rest of the page read as is. So it would be, I think the focus is actually that staff are looking at is internal operations, so we may not have to delve further, but it does throw it out there that we're not sort of steadfastly committed to a go-it-alone approach.
And I guess for me, and I can speak against it, is the purpose of this is to say, as council, staff, as a community defined as our residents, our businesses, all of those people, are the ones that set the direction for the city. core direction for the city is established by council and the community working together. So I guess that's the difference. This page is talking about who actually sets the priority for the city. It's us. Who we work with, that's a different conversation. That's all. I mean, because once you start doing the list, start adding the list, like, we've got to work with Senate, we've got to work with DC Housing, we've got to work with the Federal Department of Environment, yes.
But one of the things I do like about it is its acknowledgement to the citizens that you can't expect us to be able to do it all on our own. Mm-hmm. And so even if it's the last paragraph in that whole thing, she's saying, we recognize to achieve many of our goals will require partnerships with
our neighbors.
Our neighbors. You know, so just even on the line, mm-hmm. to say that this is our strategic plan, but we recognize that we can do it alone. The emotion to say we add.
Yep.
Councilor Roman.
I was just trying to find it because I knew it was here. It's on page 25. There is actually a very specific notation here, number 8. It says partner with regional stakeholders to address transportation issues. So maybe we could duplicate the same kind of language in a more general statement to say, as Charlene has suggested, maybe just a closing line on page 19 that acknowledges the need to work with our regional partners. Just very general.
So line at the end of the first paragraph goes.
No, at the very end. Yeah, so you've got shown figures below, city departments in line, the next step is blah, blah, blah. And then really just the one line that closes this page that says something to the effect of achieving some of these goals. We will need to work with our regional partners to achieve some of these goals. Like
and if you could add regional partners, provincial government, and federal government.
Yes.
Sure.
Okay. Thank you, Councilor Isaac. We're going to craft that up.
Well, something like we embrace partnership, regional partnerships involving other governments to address shared goals.
Yeah. Actually, more important, I think the recognition of Councilor Isaac is not embracing. It's sort of like we will work with regional partners, provincial government, and federal government to achieve this goal.
Great.
I think it's working together. That's the theme of this page. So it's about we recognize we have to work with these to accomplish the goals.
So I think it does recognize too, though, that a third of our taxes go to a regional service, like our joint service with the Esquimalt for policing. So we are already completely embedded in our core budget in a partnership that extends beyond our own jurisdiction.
That's cool.
Suggestions to staff, we shouldn't try and wordsmith or get too deep into it.
Sure.
Just get the direction. And we'll come back to this. This isn't our last talk.
Thank you.
Good. That'd be great.
Thank you.
That's the end of 19. Moving on to.
So I just want to say, it's a few to cut back that my dog is. I only get half a dog this year.
But you have a dog. And look at the half you get.
I have to flag the photo too. I'm not certain this photo is in Victoria.
Yes.
The city, the line bisects the bay, and I think this is taken at the easterly extreme of the bay, and that these people in the foreground are actually standing in front of Oak Bay logs. And we'd have to go down and do a site visit. I honestly believe a lot of those.
Yeah, exactly.
I recall from door knocking, those monster homes on the foreshore, I think maybe Oak Bay homes, and that the property line is just outside of the left of the photo.
No, where there's those. I can tell you those
houses. Oh, so they're in Victoria?
They're in Victoria.
But immediately to their right, actually, we can see the concrete abutment on the far right, and I think that's the border. So this section of beach is actually Oak Bay foreshore.
Doesn't that show working together so well?
It does, but we may need another photo. It's just but they may laugh. We may be at the butt end of someone's joke.
But I just want you to note that there are no beach fires now.
Because it's wet.
Moving on. Thank you. Page 20.
Well, but just a question, how will that be resolved? I'm looking at the map.
I think everybody else other than you is happy with that.
Yes, it is.
Well, if the houses are ugly,
be fair to staff, it could be on the spit of land on our maps here, on our desks. It could actually be on the spit of land that's right on the line. So we may be safe.
That's right below our washroom. It just happens.
The washroom's right there.
The washroom's
okay.
Right above that.
Button. Okay, fair enough.
Page 21. But suggestion change in 21. Number 5 brought in by myself. We have Councillor. So I added the fifth bullet on page 21. Councillor Helps has added some stuff in there. Councillor Eisen.
Yeah, I would speak in favor of making your priority at the top of the list. So just to throw that out there. Under grow the economy, I would prefer the word strengthen the economy. A number of experts have told us the problems of unlimited growth, and it's a debate, but I think this council is fairly progressive on social and environmental issues, and we can come to terms with the issue of the limits of growth. Strengthen the economy.
Good. Are we having a strengthen?
Yep.
Good.
Okay. And then the language around improved financial sustainability, I know we've set a guideline for 3.25%. My concern if it's in here, I guess for me, I'll throw it out, I'll be honest. I think we haven't consulted the public on it. And let's say there was a massive backlash to what 3.25% looked like in the spring. And let's say when we do go out and consult, we find there's actually support for maintaining public services, even if it meant that was 3.5%. I still support 3.25 as our target. But I think to embed it in here, when we have an annual process of tax bylaws and setting priorities, I don't know. I think it removes some discretion from council, which, to put it in this document, there's a real debate every year to have on our budget, even as we aim to a three-year budget that seeks to stay within 3.25. But it presumes a discussion that we haven't yet had with the public about whether that's a supportable goal or not. I know it's a big issue, the biggest one I wanted to raise with this document, but I think the easiest way would be a bit more flexible language, or we could decide that right here.
Thank you, Councillor Helps.
I'm violently opposed. We were elected in November. We made this decision in April. We had a long time to talk to the public on the campaign trail. We don't consult the public about every decision we make. I think we have set a very important goal as a council with, if I remember correctly, a unanimous motion. We can go ask, what do you think this looks like? But I'm very strongly in favor of keeping at or below 3.25% per year for the next 3 years.
Thank you, Councillor Alfo.
Yes, I'm also violently opposed to that proposal. Similarly to Councillor Helps' comments, I do think that it's our responsibility to try and make that very difficult balancing act where we are moderate in our fiscal management while acknowledging, in fact, the comments that the mayor has put forward in his addition of 0.5 or 0.1. We do have some very challenging decisions to make ahead of us, but I think that we're very committed to ensuring that the taxpayers have choices, but that their choices don't necessarily lead inevitably to an endlessly increasing tax rate. So I would be opposed to changing that. I think that if, in fact, as a result of our consultations, if we do hear remarkable opposition to holding the taxes at 3.25 because there is an appetite for greater service delivery or different service delivery, then we have an opportunity to revisit this. But this is the guide, this is the document that tells the public in general where we want to go. I think throughout this document there are many places where people might not be 100% in support, and I would hope that as that in fact happens, that as that becomes clear to us, that we would have the flexibility and the ability to be nimble enough to come back and alter them. So I would like to leave it right this
time. I think we're true.
Also opposed to it on a slightly different direction. My concern I have is not that we need latitude to go above. I would like it emboldened or below. The problem is
that it says that.
I know, but I would like it to be emboldened, the or below part, because I think as we put this in, it means we're going to go to 3.25, and my concern is that's, it's tough, but it's still richer than most people are seeing these days. So if we give some latitude, it only grows, it doesn't go. I want the direction to be tougher on moving the line. So I'm quite willing to support this.
that. I think it needs to be addressed. Are we, this seems like we're making a commitment to residential taxpayers, that that will be their actual increase. And I think judging from how we dealt with the tax ratio or tax share in the spring, they saw an increase of about 3.9%. So again, by being so prescriptive in this language, are we building a false expectation, or are we actually going to ensure the residential rate is no more than 3.25, which either we put more of the burden on the commercial, or we're actually going to have to aim for a 2.6 or whatever Jeff and our staff tell us that it works out to.
Language that provides certain to taxpayers, not residential taxpayers. So obviously we still hold that commitment that council has made towards share. Obviously, it's on average 3.25.
So maybe the word average. So maybe the word average could be added, just to be, so someone doesn't say you scammed me or you snitched me.
I would suggest that it's the overall tax increase is 3.25%. That was sort of the what we've been working for budget is that
the
tax
overall
revenue.
Annual tax increase. There you go.
Great.
Or even just the word average thrown in before.
It's not average.
Oh, it's not average.
Unfortunately, it would be our tax revenue will increase at 3.25.
The overall average tax increase will remain
overall, not annual.
The overall annual tax increase will remain at or below 3.25. Okay, let's throw that language in. Everybody okay with that, generally? Council Madoff?
I am. I just wonder at one point in our discussion there had been a suggestion that it would be the accrued tax increase over the 3 years, that 1 year might be 3.5, and then by the strategy of 3.0 for next year. So that does that preclude that? That's precluded in this language.
My understanding was that that was a discussion. That was, I think, an original position, mm-hmm. was that it was over the 3 years, and then council decided that no, it would be 3.25% per year. So it's not the cumulative. So it does preclude.
So I just wanted to make sure that that is an opportunity that would be lost, even if there was a clear understanding in the next year the financial situation was going to be dramatically different for whatever particular reason could be identified with certainty by council.
Well, we put it in, I mean, council fundamentally, if a year of situation changes, mm-hmm. we can change our policy, this is an expression of our intention and our commitment. The economy totally tanks next year. Just not working on it, so things are going to change. And it totally improves. With the addition of overall annual tax increase, anything else?
Could you please repeat the number 5 bullet? Can we see the bullet or what? The one that you wanted to add, or you're going to craft it, or what?
You have to craft it.
Yes, the bullet will be along the theme of enhancing the quality of life for our residents, because that brings together the transportation, Crystal Pool, and all of the other kind of community
crosswalks.
Yeah, okay. It kind of patches a lot of things that aren't capturing these four.
Great.
So we'll craft some words in that.
Thank you.
Councilor Alto?
Yeah, under the second topic of growing the economy, I can't think of a circumstance where any city would be a natural place to do business. I don't know what that means. So I would rather actually just delete the first few words and start the sentence with the strength of our economy.
Mm-hmm.
Great. The strength of our economy is the foundation for supporting our entire community, and just to go on. Because I don't know what the natural place to do business means or what that would be.
The sort of place you'd want to go to.
Yeah, but I don't think that captures
not
that. So
no.
We just start the sentence with the strength of our economy is.
Thank you. Councilor Thorpe, sure. And Councilor Maverick.
And Mr. Chair, we agree that the number 5 is going to be up to the top of the list. I think
I think that's good.
Okay, and everybody's okay with that moving up? Councilor Maverick?
Yep.
Have we agreed on the change of title for point 2 to strengthen the economy versus grow the economy? Is that
yep.
that?
Yep.
And then it seems to be first sentence.
Yep.
That's
yeah,
exactly.
Mm-hmm. That's great.
That's what I thought.
Any other changes to page 21? Awesome. Moving on to page 23.
Wait, 22.
Could we be working here?
Yeah.
Are you sure that's in the city of Victoria?
Well, it would be nice to have us at work.
Yes, it would.
No.
So, Councilor Young doesn't want us working.
I don't want us in the
future.
Perhaps a suggestion would be this,
oh, yeah.
And I understand what you want to capture on this. There are some amazing amazing photos of us holding and hosting open houses in this chamber that I think we can probably find a busy, active citizen engagement within City Hall that will reflect what we want to do, as opposed to council sitting around doing mics.
Great.
But that would be great.
We'll see what we can find.
Thanks. Because that sort of signals that open and accessible City Hall. Thank you. On page 23.
On the strategy four, I don't recall council providing any policy direction to move towards user pay self-funded programs. So I favor striking out.
Can someone please identify where number four came from?
I was actually, and the first half I'm fine with. I would propose striking out anything from including on after the comment.
Identify and implement changes to city service delivery that result in cost savings and benefits.
Period. Wouldn't preclude the action described, but it wouldn't commit us to it either, since we haven't had that discussion at the beginning.
Improving the transition to user-based self-funded programs were appropriate. The question I have on that is, are we being duplicitous? Are we misleading? If that's the reason, no, but you know what I mean? Like, if council has a direction where it says, we want you to investigate user-paid self-funded programs where appropriate, then I don't want to pretend that we're not looking at that.
But when did we, well, maybe I haven't been privy to those discussions.
Yes?
It is in our financial sustainability policy that's adopted by council, so that's wording directly from our financial sustainability policy.
Okay, so it's, now we know where it came from. Thank you. Councilor Mello?
How
did
you say that that's just one component? Not to be specific, because if we were really going to, if you're concerned about not being misleading, this would be an exhaustive list of everything we might be looking at. So I think just any
okay, everybody's generally end up with a period.
Yeah, actually.
Get rid of including the transition, blah, blah, blah. Okay?
So that will end after benefits?
Done.
Yeah.
Great.
Anything else on page 23? Under key initiatives, pursue naming rights for Victoria Crawford Center. Wasn't there supposed to be a public consultation on this issue?
I've got a question mark.
We voted on it.
Okay, I just want to make sure I okay, not there, done.
It's not there.
Okay.
Is that okay? Pursue is not seen as too limiting. We thought that encompassed the whole exploration or examination.
Yes. Okay. Approved is for we have, frankly, in my mind, a legal obligation to be approved. Councilor Isaac?
I'd like to propose an amendment that we change pursue naming rights to explore naming rights for Victoria Conference Center.
I believe the direction of the vote was that, which reflects that
direction. Is that what it actually said?
Yeah.
Yep.
I know, I think it was maybe an in-camera discussion, so.
Was it maybe
it was? Oh, maybe it was, actually. It was on the 28th, we voted.
Can we just confirm what the language is in the document?
Let's look at
it's
the
in
vote.
The minutes. Hold on.
I'm not sure what page it's
on. Page 8.
Yeah, okay.
The shoe sale name rights, they're real. Done.
Sarah. Yeah, you did.
So it reflects the vote. Don't want to re-vote on something like that. Thank you. Anything else on page 23? None. Okay, 23 is happy. Speaking of happy, 24 is happy.
Yeah.
25. On page 25, I want to add on page 8, page 8, on strategies number 8, says partner with regional stakeholders to address transportation issues. I wanted to somehow change that to reflect council's direction of being more dynamic. We had a big discussion around our regional transportation. It was both, we went from study and improve. So I wanted more dynamic statement in there. Apart from so I don't want to address transportation issues. I mean, where's the minutes? I think we basically said examine and improve public transportation options.
And that's contained in the initiatives to the right. The key initiative there is to examine and improve public transportation options. Strategy is a broader way of saying we're doing that with the community.
Okay. I think also under there, under key initiatives, I would try to ask, okay with that then? Under key initiatives, we need to put the fire hall under this one. That's probably more best under our community.
It's under our environment.
Yeah, kind of maybe weird to think about that. Improving our, it's about social sustainability, meaning responding to crisis, taking care of infrastructure.
The reason it's under environment.
I couldn't quite figure out why improving our fire hall is under environment.
Because that one has goals around the built environment as well as the natural environment. So asset management and things that we do to improve our assets or our built city would fall under environment. I recognize that's a little awkward.
And for me, it's nice to have a nice built environment that way. That's not the reason why I built a fire hall. It's for the people who are
so
community.
It's public safety kind of thing.
Yeah, that's
okay.
So anyways, people wildly disagree that fire hall should not go under there. Secondly, I think that's where we also list our affordable housing initiatives. It needs to be under one of the key initiatives. And I think that is initiative number. Where?
Third bullet. Under key initiatives.
Sorry, I read it and missed it completely. Thank you. It's there. Anybody else on page 25? No, that's blown all my three. Councillor Gutton?
Well, back with the partner with regional stakeholders to address, it says transportation issues, but can't we implement the line that we implemented earlier on?
Yeah.
Any issues that affect all of us, it's not limited to transportation, so that can be adapted there. And as far as key initiatives, our community is our waterfront too. So if we're going to go down the road of the fire hall, then I would argue that it was my understanding that one of our main strategic initiatives was a waterfront plan. So it's under, I know it is under our economy, but if we're going to put fire hall under here, it's our community as well. It's our quality of life when we enjoy the waterfront for our community. So I would, if we do one, then I'd like to add.
I'm sorry, which one? Are you talking about the Dallas Road Bluffs?
No, I'm talking about our harbor
waterfront revitalization.
It's currently into what?
Economy.
I have a suggestion.
And I don't really see Vanessa's,
I have a suggestion. This is what we did in the OCT, if I recall, is it would say, see also, so you can see that we're addressing it as under a number of issues. Just a little bracket. See also our economy key initiatives. So that shows that we get that community and economy are connected, community and environment are connected. Does that work as a way of?
Well, we already did that 3 pages earlier when we talked about the interconnectedness.
Yeah, but I'm saying, I'm just trying to solve the problem of having specific initiatives. Some people think they should be one place, some people think they should be another place. If we both agree that they could be these two places, see also solves the problem.
Okay. I guess for me on the document, I don't want to start cross-referencing page to page, so if you don't like fire hall there, then leave it under our environment.
One of the things we can emphasize more, we have it on one of the pages there, is that, and it's actually a good thing to have, is that a lot of the things that we're working on address multiple priorities, multiple goals, and multiple sectors.
Yeah.
So it's always a decision about where does it fit best. So we decided what we thought the strategies linked to the goals, and the initiatives kind of flow from there. So many of these you could argue could be in one
all
or more places.
Yes.
On page 17 it says, as shown in the figure below, these four areas are not mutually exclusive. Our strategies integrated, complementary, and interdependent. I just thought fire hall fit better within our environment because for me
that
was one of the higher priority.
Okay.
The question, folks, do we want to move forward? Shelley's suggestion of, I'm sorry, I lost it. Harbor Waterfront. Do you feel that it belongs more in the community or more under economic development? Let me finish. Are you speaking specifically to that? Councillor Ross.
Yeah. Harbor, I think, is a perfect example of like a triple bottom line, social, environmental, economic. I think, but this, these pages primarily, I think, are communicating the goals to the public, and economy will become very light if we reapportion it, even though I think I'm, my views are probably similar to those of Councillor Gudgeon, that I'm most interested in the community benefits of the harbor and the environmental benefits, but I can live with it being an economy, so we don't live with it, end up with a bunch of lopsided pages. And when we deliberate at this table, yeah, all three will come into play.
Okay, thank you. Councillor Walton.
Despite the language that you read out on page 17, I wonder if it would be possible to describe somewhere appropriate in the document just what Jenna said about the fact that these are all interconnected and you know, while they may be presented in a particular area, that shorter language than this, obviously, that it is an integrated representational plan, and so you will... Just because it's on one page doesn't mean it doesn't affect it by other topics.
We can elaborate on that point.
Yeah, somewhere in there.
Anybody else have issues around page 25?
Page 25.
Councillor Isaac.
One quick follow-up, too, to the economic benefits of a public realm waterfront. San Francisco, their waterfront is an engine of economic growth. So just to make that final point. That a public waterfront is a huge... Oh, sorry. Okay, I wasn't going to change it, but just to add that.
That's a great point. We love to hear it.
At some point.
Councillor Thornton, any other changes to this page? Councillor Gudgeon, any changes to this page?
No.
Okay, thank you. Page 27. And some good points have been made on page 27.
I'm already done with them.
Thank you. Councillor Thornton, Joe.
Episode 26, I'll go over to shoot the... We love having Microsoft and the data center. I like the idea of the pictures of the small business.
Yeah.
Mm.
Good one.
Oh,
but I just want the commerce stuff.
I agree.
Torn between the great that Microsoft isn't down. We want to celebrate that.
But the trophy atrium building, maybe.
Yeah.
NBC
Ferries. NBC Ferries? You want to get free advertising?
But I do love the bar.
Yeah,
we don't sell them. Discovery Economic Consulting on Landwind.
Don't
you have to recuse yourself from possession of
that place?
Bill Tarazzo is a lovely picture.
Yes, it is. It's a lovely
community microfunding that was great.
And I guess the question I have for staff is, who's the target audience for this?
You know what I think part of the
What's the use of this? I mean, we're trying to sell somebody that we're high tech and we want to move it. People aren't impressed by that. That's one thing.
That is part of the reason that the emerging high-tech industry, but it was also because it's a heritage building that's been nicely restored, and it overlooks one of our biggest taxpayers, which is the Bay Center. So there was sort of those thoughts behind it.
Councillor Alto?
Well, several of the people have suggested it, and I don't know if it's possible given the configuration of the photograph, but if it was possible to do two pictures.
Yeah.
Where you had, I like this representation as an investor draw, but I also think it's completely valid to have some interesting looking, quirky looking small business as well.
Maybe somewhere else. We've only got one picture per page everywhere else.
So maybe, but maybe there could
maybe
be
one of the other pictures.
Or given the fact that this is an almost embarrassingly light page, there could be a photo on the right hand side as well.
Yeah, that's a good idea.
Because otherwise, the question I had about page 27 was, is that all we can put in to our economy? I mean, I understand that the first bullet on the key initiative is a huge one because it speaks to the economic development strategy, which in and of itself has many components. But because they're not elucidated there, I mean, it looks like a really light page.
We can add some of the components.
Okay, then maybe that would be good.
Thank you. Councillor Rising?
Yeah, I think if there is only going to be one photo, I think it does send the wrong message that primarily we have to have a vital local enterprise economy. If that's supplemented by multinational and actors from outside of the capital region, great. But it needs a local cafe or something, even if there's a backdrop of some transnational American-based firm.
Company right there.
What's that?
Kempen Company is right there.
I can't even see it.
We do have a large stock of photos.
To highlight Microsoft and the Bay, I think it's a bit of an insult to the 1,000 plus local business operators who have great operations downtown. So
perhaps the solution I recognize a little bit here, is there another? We're looking for an opportunity to add local business in, not delete this one.
I think a hybrid would be perfect. Yeah,
a photo montage would work for that page as well. You still have the image.
Well, there might be an opportunity to do, yeah.
Might be some other way to work that in without sort of changing the design of the document too mm-hmm. drastically, but are you okay to keep this picture in? Which we can replace it with a small business oriented picture if that's your preference.
I think
what we've heard is a photo montage that includes several of those. I mean, I love the picture of Jimmy standing on the side of Pacific with, you know, and Jimmy and his wife standing on the side of the Pacific.
Yeah.
We got that whole photo, but anyways, there's...
Okay,
thank you. Councillor Helps.
Yeah, I don't want us to... I appreciate that there's a lot of white space on this page, but I was really struck by what Janice said at the beginning, that this is a very focused document. I don't remember if it was Janice or Gail that said it. It's a very focused document. The last one, and I read it with interest when I was elected, it like goes all the way down all the pages. I think let's keep it sparse. Let's not just add stuff in so it looks better. These are the things that we want to do. Let's do them. Let's not add in things just so there's not so much white space.
In fact, white space is the tendency now that people move to those documents. Thank you. Is there anything else under the economy, Councillor Alto?
Yeah, I agree with that in general, but I do think it would be helpful to add in at least some sample of what the economic development strategy is, because most people don't know.
That
would
be good.
Not to necessarily clutter up the page, yeah. But just to elucidate a little bit on that, because people go, oh yeah, what is that? It'd be great to have some samples.
Thank you.
I just have a comment.
And maybe you can actually put we highlight the name of studies that can have different full code. If you could add that in there, then it drives people to our website to know that they can find that document if they want all of that. So that's what you do. Thank you, Councillor Bedford.
Well, I don't know if this is the right time. It's just a comment I had when I first saw it, and I think it applies to this page, so that's why I'll just articulate my. When I first saw this morning, actually, unfortunately I didn't get it last night, when I left our meeting, I thought that the harbor waterfront was one of our top five strategic goals for the next 3 years. And in this document, it feels buried at the back. It's on the second point, and it's less a focus on working with partners and redeveloping our waterfront land. Now it's develop a feasibility study. You know, it just seems very, very, very watered down in the new document. And I've been telling people, wow, we're gonna work on our harbor, thinking that that's what was decided. Perhaps I misunderstood what was presented to us last week, but I felt that our harbor was going to become a real important strategic focus for this council term. And it just feels watered down now in this new document. So it's just...
So you thought it was something at a higher level than just an initiative?
It's just a study, and we might work towards it. It just feels very watered down from when I'm looking at the document on page 7 of 29, where it says that it was ranked number 4 on a must-do, you know, something that we need to focus on, and yet it's rather buried on this page and in this full document. It's not mentioned or referred to anywhere in any blurb or any the importance of our harbor to the health of Victoria. It's what separates us from every other city is our harbor, and I don't see a focus on that in this document at all. But
so
that's just my thoughts, and I'm willing to hear what other people have to say.
I'm wondering if we could throw that in also on page 21, but well, we talk about a commitment for the annual tax increase meaning 3.25, which is pretty specific. So we say Victoria's, so we've done that small change, but I wonder under number 2, you know, strengthen the economy, blah, 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 blah. Somewhere in there, you know, we recognize
the importance of our harbor to the
recognize
economic
our importance of our harbor,
yeah, that'd be good.
Leading
yeah.
our economy yeah. strategy, something
right.
like
we
that.
We can find something. It's
could you add it in a number 2, page 21?
Just to highlight,
brings it up in the priority of notice. Okay, thank you. Councillor Isaac?
I had some language that could be a final line. Engage the community and partners to revitalize Victoria's harbor. There's maybe a last sentence in 2.
It really is the gateway for the region. Mm-hmm. And I think understanding that is important.
Okay,
great.
Excellent. Anything else under our economy, page 27? Councillor Mahal?
My other comment is about the state of the attempt to work with this is I'm very concerned that
Mr. Alto?
I think it would go in economy, but it might also be better in community. And although I can't put my finger on a particular priority, there is no reference in here at all to arts and culture. And so I don't want to invent a priority or a key initiative, but perhaps in the beginning somewhere, I mean, there is some language that could at least acknowledge it being part of the wealth of the community, yeah, the vibrancy of the community.
A particular part of the larger mission paragraph, but that might be the only place it occurs because it wasn't the council priority.
No, I know.
Build anything around that specifically.
Yeah, okay.
I think though, the fact is a lot of city resources do that, so that could be something as simple on page 27, a strategy 11, that could be support festivals, culture, and the arts, which is what we do. Well, not adding it as an initiative, so not, because the strategies are more general, aren't they?
There's something that the initiatives will flow from that, so that's a strategy that would suggest you have specific action you want to highlight as well. I think that wasn't one of the ones you chose.
Yeah, you're right.
Doesn't mean we don't care.
Yeah, we can just say we're...
I think up front we could.
Well, we can talk about it in terms of talking about this community overall.
Because we do it anyway.
That's
part of the course.
Well,
the reason that I thought of it as economy is because, you know, we've heard so much about how much it drives our economy, the various things that we all know.
Actually,
I want to create something out of nothing.
One of the strategies in the strat plan is around that.
Yeah.
So we can actually put that.
Yeah, we also...
Sorry, Ben, I know this was Shelley and then...
Oh, no, I think it was Ben, but...
You're happy? You don't want to...
Oh, I'm not. I mean, I can go on and on about the importance, how the harbor dovetails into each and every one of these, and I believe it actually needs its own page, is what I would add. But having said that, if we can find another prominent place for it, I think it's critical to the well-being of our future.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Well, just following up on Mary Ann's comments, arts and culture. When I was concerned about even the OCP, I think I could emphasize further, but I took some comfort in this document. If you look at number 10, Eugene's investment programs enhance the vibrancy and economy of downtown Victoria, and then you go back up to bullet 2, and it identifies the city as a vibrant center of cultural activities. If you're trying to make an argument to fund the arts, you do link both of those to the argument.
Do we add, would it make it stronger if we added business and arts and cultural activities? Do we add arts and culture as opposed to just cultural activities?
Yeah,
actually
that's good, because we do refer to it in page 3 as arts and culture.
Arts and cultural
activity.
Okay, arts and culture. Everybody okay with that? Great, Councillor Eisner.
Yeah, just looking at environment, they're relevant to this. We have a lot of items there that don't have key initiatives attached. So take action to mitigate climate change. That's not one of our top 20 priorities. Incent for green business. It's not a priority, but it's a strategy that's identified. So I don't see why we couldn't have a strategy 11 to support festivals, culture, and the arts. It's a number of the strategies listed are just current and ongoing city operations that haven't been flagged as one of our top 20 new. So there wouldn't be inconsistent with what's listed in other parts of the document. Well, but to beef up, we only have 2 economic development strategies, so that would just be one that we already do. We spend millions every year on those initiatives.
I don't have any objection to creating a new 11 that references arts and culture, but I don't think I'd want to include festivals specifically, because arts and culture is the breadth. And if I'm going to pick festivals, I'm going to pick 6 other things that I like to.
Sure. So support arts and culture? Or?
Continuing. The continuing is the piece.
Yeah.
Yes.
Because if you go to enhancing, then it presumes more money, new things, whatever. So continuing to invest in programs and enhance the vibrancy and economy of downtown Victoria, you could easily just duplicate that sentence and say something to the effect of continuing to support arts and culture programs or activities in the city or something.
Yeah. Anything else you want to break that up from there?
No.
I don't care. Sounds good. We want to enhance the back to 11, which is 10 continue to invest in programs and enhance the vibrancy and economy down to Victoria. continue to invest in arts and cultural programs that enhance the vibrancy of the country.
Or something.
Maybe not just in town.
Yeah, no, no. No, in Victoria.
That enhance the economy of Victoria.
Yeah.
Hell, you say greater Victoria, because...
That will be somewhat, I think the first part is to continue to support arts and cultural programs in the city. Just so it doesn't, the lines don't look identical.
Okay, but you say greater Victoria, because you give towards the CRD Arts Fund.
No, we're at...
But it's partnership, it's real.
Go stuff, go stuff.
Thank you. Jeff, you staying in there with us, buddy? Sorry, sir.
I will.
Barely, by my fingernails.
Our environment?
One.
Yes, thank you.
One proposed change to the second key initiative, which is consistent with our priorities and your worship's comments and others. If we could add implement Dallas Bluff Stabilization Project and pursue greenway and infrastructure improvements along waterfront, whether we identify it as the Dallas Road waterfront or not.
Let's break it out as a separate bullet. I think that's important.
Okay.
The key initiatives is Johnson Street Bridge, Dallas Road Bluff. We need another bullet that basically talks about...
pursue...
I would say Dallas Road, the balustrade, as well as... other
yeah, so pursue greenway and infrastructure improvements along Dallas Road waterfront. Because the infrastructure is the balustrade, the greenway is what we can maybe do with the CRD.
Yeah, separate bullet would be good. Yeah, for what we can. Thank you. Everybody okay with that? For not yet, okay, Councillor Helms.
I just, are we really going to be done the fire hall by 2015?
Damn right.
Okay, that's my only question.
Especially if it's a rehabilitation.
Can someone tell me in what dictionary incent is a verb?
Yeah.
Number 12. Please take that out and use any other word.
It's been showing up a lot, not just in city documents, though.
And it drives me mad. Okay. It is not a verb. Yes, it is. It doesn't. It'll have to be more than one word, unfortunately.
English is a living language.
Oh no, not that badly. No. Yes, it's really. I'm okay with most things, but that one drives me mad.
Just some clarification, please, on the initiative proposed around greenways. That wasn't one of the council priorities, as I recall, and development of greenways and pathways would be considered part of our ongoing capital programs, and a lot of those things, if they weren't specified as a particular priority project, aren't identified here. So that kind of opens the door to all sorts of other
things.
Number
11 on our sheet. Maximize infrastructure and transportation improvement opportunities developed in City Street and construction on Dallas Road. I think what Councillor Ives and I agree with him is part of what we talked about under there was the opportunity was to
put up
improve trip. You know, it was more of alternate sidewalks, bike lanes, and the Dallas Road balustrade, which I think is its own item. So captured within that concept of greenways, we can maybe change it slightly to alternate transportation.
The thing is, I think it does. It's something that would be supportable by residents to use that land. But if the road's being torn up, to have a greenway on it when it's put back together, I think is a very supportable goal. So rather than blur the issue, are we putting more buses on Dallas Road? I don't think so. We're actually saying let's give people some modest infrastructure when it's put back together.
So if you can wordsmith a little bit, I recognize that part of the work is for our parks and our public works to go out, see what's being dug up, what opportunities to present, that's going to come back to council. So I don't exclude or preclude or include that, whatever, but.
One word is we could do explore rather than pursue. So explore greenway and infrastructure improvements along Dallas Road waterfront.
Sure.
Yes, and we can, that one initiative that is on the priority list, but because it was an ongoing initiative, there's really some language that kind of knocks it up a little bit, so that it looks like it has more of a strategic impact for you.
Great, thank you. Everybody happy with page 29? It's our environment. Okay, done. Thank you. Performance targets.
I just have to come back on that. The last Janice's comment, just with the relevance though, is that we have to realize there's ongoing operating costs to maintain 60 feet of pavement. So I don't envision what needs to happen at Dallas Road does not involve future any more operating costs. It's just how do we put that public right-of-way back together once there's a new sewer pipe in the ground? So it's that simple, I think. I'm not proposing that we grow our parks budget. with that specific item. It's just what do we replace that public right of way with after it's been torn up?
On the indicators? I'm on the next pages.
Okay, we're on indicators.
Yeah.
Thank you very much. Page 30, Councilor Joe. Councilor Joe.
Oh, okay.
My thing that I thought was missing part of the community is a sense of the work that we're doing for homelessness and housing. And I'm trying to think where we're going with, you know, especially when this came out of BioSan's office. First, I thought the first one indicated the percentage of residents with the word quality of life in terms of quality of life for all. So it's something that needs something that reflects the work that we're doing. I'm not sure whether these men can you pull it all together.
It's good for all of our citizens.
What? It's not.
No, it doesn't say that. That's created.
Yeah, so there needs to be something. So I don't know whether we can.
Well, no, this is where an opportunity where we can put it on our person where else have read that, but is, you know, part of our strategic goal is more affordable housing and rentals. Like, do we have,
It's not part of our strategic goal is to do the housing strategy and incent housing to get built.
Give incentive, whatever.
So
take a look. We feel that some of the things like, part of our strategic priorities is to enhance public transportation. Is it how many more kilometers of bike lanes? Is it X amount of increase? Whatever. I mean, we've got to. So, and what Charlene's saying is give us real numbers around our goals around the
affordable housing
and home cities. Which is almost as an honor with really when we've got that through.
So, staff do monitor the affordable housing and things like housing units created, that sort of thing. And we report all those in the annual report in a way that shows, to provide some context for the work of the city, because we only want measures in here that the city can be held accountable for and that we can actually measure ourselves on. So certainly the city's role in any of these partnerships or making things happen is one thing, but taking the responsibility of trying to be accountable for things that are not at your discretion entirely is a bit problematic from that perspective. But, and we do track and monitor all sorts of other things around, talk about kilometers of roads and sidewalks and all of that. We didn't see those necessarily as things that were put into a strategic document, but when you see the business plans and those kinds of things, the annual reports, that's when you see all kinds of activity that we measure and monitor on an ongoing basis. If you feel that you want some of those in the strategic plan, we can do that, but we wanted to limit it so that it wasn't looking like an overwhelming document for other folks to read, but know that we have literally hundreds of indicators that we can track and report on a regular basis.
Right, and we want to see those. But I think what Councilor Joe and I are saying is that this is an important issue, so you do track what's important. So under 14 it says, develop and implement policies and initiatives to facilitate affordable rental housing and home ownership. And under the strategy, it's about the diversity of housing choices to support future population needs.
So indicator number one, see if it's us. Percentage of residents who rate the overall quality and affordability of life.
Yes.
In Victoria is good.
That's good.
Would that capture the
affordability? That's good.
That's all it
does.
Quality
of life. Yeah. Affordability is the key to go there.
I like to kick table. I like to have something solid that you actually did. And it's important to have a happiness indicator, right? Are you happier today than you were yesterday? But do you not think there's value to actually say we created X amount of, or over this 3-year period?
We're not creating units. It's not our priority.
Spending $35,000 in that first year to have people create more stuff. So we may not physically be building it ourselves, but we're trying to facilitate and create that stuff.
But I think that's what Janice is saying. If we can't do it ourselves, then we shouldn't be measuring it. We can't measure whether there's going to be a good bus system or not. We can do our best to make sure it happens, but we can't measure it because it's not all our responsibility on our own.
We can measure our contribution to that, what we did to provide those incentives or how many
certain things you probably could pull out of that. I can speak to the folks working on that strategy and see what kinds of things we would have and be able to measure ourselves on. Then we can add something like that in here around the affordable.
I'm just concerned that we're not going to take a whole lot of credit from the economic climate that we're in right now, where we're getting a lot of private sector is doing a lot of affordable housing because they have to, because the vacancy rate is quite high right now. So it's basically, we can all pat ourselves on the back, but it's more economic, and there's parts that are out of our control. And if we can all go, wow, look at what we've done, when it's actually happening before our eyes right now. So it's a very complex, and the real estate board, I think, and other organizations, the CRD is taking that on. From what I recall, it wasn't one of our priorities at all. I'm looking at it on to highlight it.
What was one of our priorities?
Building affordable housing was not one of our priorities.
Is that about building affordable housing?
Well, why would we highlight it?
For measuring.
Sorry, but what is our priority? I'm sorry, but what is our priority, which we moved to number one, which included, is develop and implement policies and initiatives that will facilitate affordable rental housing and home ownership. And how we get there, obviously we need other people to build it, and the rest of the stuff, right? Councilor Alto?
Janice made a suggestion which I think might resolve this, and that is to provide some language around our evaluation of our contributions. And that isn't necessarily financial contributions, but it may be, in fact, our policy and decisions around land use, around, you know, some various people who talk about different programs and providing incentives for, you know, building affordable housing, whatever those are. But those would be something that would be within our own authority, for which we're not taking credit for other people's work. And, in fact, illustrating how we're supplementing and working with other investors. So maybe you could explore some language.
I think we can come up with something. And we want to be careful too, in the strategic plan, you want to be looking at outcomes and not just, you know, outputs, activity levels and transactions and things like that. So that's why you might not see a lot of things you used to see, for example, being reported out annually, is because they're a different level of measurement, and we want to put all of those in this document. And many of these things that you see residents believe, businesses believe, those are all things that are sourced from the citizen and business surveys that you do every 3 years. So those questions and those kinds of responses are built into that survey. Not to say we can't adjust the questions or do different things there, but that is sort of the source of the expected.
Okay, moving under, any more issues around, so that was controlling Clerk and Joe. Councillor Helps and Councillor Tom.
Are we looking at just page 30 or 30 and 31?
30 for now.
Okay, just a question. Under our city government, number 3, non-property tax revenue as percentage of total baseline, 41%. Our target is to maintain that, although lots of language in here is about exploring alternate sources of revenue. So I'm just curious about why we wouldn't want to try and increase it. I know we like to be conservative, but maybe Brenda?
I thought Brenda explained, yeah, the finance staff had I had the same question. The finance staff could say better than I can as to why that may not necessarily change the overall picture. Is that something, Brenda or Suzanne, that you could respond to?
Well, I think the key point is that when we have the discussions on alternate revenue sources, it's we have very little opportunities to do it, so we're just being conservative.
Right, okay. That's good for now. I have another question about the next page, but...
Okay, anybody have other issues on page 30? Councillor
Target for 2015 being defined as maintained, I don't find helpful.
I'm sorry, where are you, Chris?
On page 31, so it's the
31?
Page 30. It shows up again on
our city government.
Under our city government, non property tax revenue, 41% in 2011.
Yep.
We're going to maintain that.
Okay.
What does that maintain mean? We're going to maintain the 41%, we're going to maintain the absolute dollar value. We're talking about a tax lift of up to 3.25%. Are we maintaining 41% of an increasing number? So I would rather, as we've done in other places, if we actually give a target, stay at 41%. That's fine. Or recognize a declining percentage of it. I don't find it. It shows up particularly on the next page. I really don't want us to go there yet, but net number of new businesses 50. maintain that number.
Yep.
That number of business license renewals, maintain that number. Well, that means the 50 you've got coming in 1 year are leaving the next year. So I don't understand what maintain means.
So on page 30, our suggestion is on the second and the third, get rid of maintain and under target for 2015, 41%. So get rid of maintain for 41%. Get rid of maintain on the third line and put it 37%.
In other sectors, we've actually seen a number of residents and businesses who agree that City Hall listens to them. We're projecting growth from 69% in 2010 to 75% for residents.
Sorry, where are you now?
Just down a little in that column. Even percentages showing growth.
Double the number of indicators.
So we have a goal to increase that.
Yeah, okay. That's fine. I just don't maintain as
much. Oh, okay. So you're emphasizing the same.
Yeah.
Any other changes on page 30? Councillor Isaac?
Well, Councillor Phelps just mentioned it. I support it. Mentioned it under her breath, but it's a great suggestion. Just numbering all the indicators for ease of measurement and also reporting purposes.
Just put numbers.
Put a column on the left-hand side, numbering all the indicators.
Oh, okay.
Good. Thank you. Okay. Everybody's happy with page 30 now? Now, page 31. Councillor Helps.
Bottom, our environment condition index rating for all city asset classes. I would suggest, and I can be corrected by the director of engineering, but roads should be roads and bike lanes, and then there should be a new bullet, parks and greenways, because those are city assets and we want to have them listed, not just all these hard assets.
Gail, what do you have for parks?
Well, Mr. Sturdy, okay, they're both here.
Any issues with that?
Parks, greenways become condition assets.
And we add roads, sidewalks, and bike lanes.
I mean, certainly we can report out separately. There would be an issue for us, so we should have them separate. Just to keep them
well, they're not even here at all. Parks and greenways aren't here. So I'm suggesting adding them. And then roads, bike lanes, and sidewalks.
The sidewalks we can include. Bike lanes, I'm not sure we track that separately from the roads.
Well, if nothing else, it's measured in how well they're marked.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
something like that, just because it's our priority. So.
Okay, so we're adding in roads, sidewalks, and bike lanes.
And then a new bullet.
So then a new bullet will include parks and greenways. I'm looking for head nods. Great, thank you. Councillor Isaac, new item.
Do we need our director of parks to flag the baseline assessment, or is it good? Is it fair? I guess that's something.
We expect that you will add the baseline.
Sure. I think we need a baseline for the climate action goals there. It looks really bad, like despite all the funds we've invested, that
right.
The two non-applicable baselines.
Reduction in human and greenhouse gas emissions.
It's certainly applicable. We might not
I would hope available. That we actually, how do we know we're going to meet a 2020 target where we didn't know where we started from?
So do we not actually have those numbers?
So we should be able to get those numbers.
Yeah, because like 8 years ago on the Environment Committee when I was just a citizen.
Yes, we got those numbers. Can we please put real numbers in there? NA and NA?
We don't actually have those numbers available quite yet. Sustainability Department is working on that, and we will be coming, I think, forward to GPC at a later date. But once we have those, then we would look for those numbers and be able to report out on those. It's just a little bit premature for them to
be. Even if it's around the ballpark.
Let's pick this up. Let's just pick it up. We have signed on to the Climate Charter of Action. It says we will reduce our greenhouse gases by 33% by
2020.
Yes.
When is the start date?
2008.
Right. Baseline, 2008. So reduction of human greenhouse gases, baseline is 2008. Yes, you will give us exactly where we were in 2008 shortly, but we know that 2008 was our start date.
Yes. I think we have that data we can insert that.
Yes, but for now, under baseline, we're 2008, because that's when we're starting to measure, right? That's
yeah, see, but I'm hearing that we might not have the number for 08.
We don't have it yet, but we'll have those figures
so
at some point in the future.
Gosh, is there no way we have even working numbers that could be rounded? Because I don't, like literally in 2000.
We're not debating it at the moment. We're giving direction. Staff will come back.
All I'm saying from an indicator,
like,
yeah.
7 years ago when this council appointed me, this continuous body, appointed me to that committee, we were talking about those numbers then. So people have them.
I totally agree. Perhaps, let me try and convince you one more time.
Yes.
We have made a commitment. And the commitment started in 2008.
Yes.
So to prove that we're reduced by 33%, we have to have a start date. And the start date is 2008.
Yes.
So let's just put 2008 there.
But I'm hearing that we may, those numbers may still be crunched. So I think we just have to tell the sustainability department we need some ballpark numbers, something better than to be confirmed.
I'll go back to the sustainability.
Thank you.
We've got ballpark. I'm just saying, but if the ballpark numbers are related to 2008.
Exactly. I agree. That's a good year.
And some of our buildings do have information. Conference Center, for example, has an information. So we can put something together.
So for today, we'll put in 2008. We're going to look for more ballpark numbers.
Yes.
Great. Everybody happy with that? Perfect. Any other changes also?
Just a question on page 31. Under our economy, the second and third measures, percentage of residents going to the right place for good development, percentage of businesses, regulatory environment and fair. The targets for me seem a little low, mm-hmm. a little on the conservative side. If those numbers are, the baseline numbers are accurate, they're a bit on the low side. And I would hope that in particular with these two, I mean, there are a couple of others on the other page, but these two in particular for me are addressed by an assertive implementation of our customer service strategy. And so if that's actually going to succeed, I would hope for a higher target to 2015 than just 1% and 2%.
So new suggestions, please.
Well, I would shoot for 85 and 85.
Done. And if you don't meet the target, part of it is the evaluation of why you didn't do it.
That's right.
It may or may not be in your control. Thank you. Councillor Eisenberg?
Yeah, follow up on Councillor Coleman's point about the three maintains. So I think 50 would be for the new licenses. Then it would be adding up 50 over 4 years to get a 2015 renewal figure. And I think we would want to index direct spending to inflation.
3 years.
Well, except it's 2011 is the baseline, so it's 4 years. So yeah, we had, you're right, 200. So it'd be 9,517. And I think whether we put it at 6 million, or I think we have to add inflation, because 5 million of spin-off spending on arts would actually be falling behind. Well, with inflation, we don't want to be at 5 million of direct spending from art for the third indicator, maybe 6 million. I think that would be where inflation would take us by 2015, or 5.5 million, but that the same figure is actually falling back because it's less actual purchasing power and less real spending, because it's in 2015 dollars. The same way our city budget is not going to be. So, 5.5 would be a very modest, conservative estimate maybe, but.
I just think it would be useful to base on something especially with arts and culture. If you put a really high figure, then it's not met. That's not going to enhance the environment of the arts and cultural sector. So something that we actually based on something we can track in terms of how it has ramped up over a similar period of time, that factors in inflation as well.
Kate, can you help us on this?
Through you, Worship, I was actually just going to indicate that honestly, the customer data are accurate. I think we need to be, in this economic climate, just making sure that we can keep the same kind of impact that we're staying, that is happening right now and it's stabilizing. I understand the commentary about inflation and so on. So that's why we, I think we're maintaining is trying to capture the number of events and the direct local spending that happens because of that. It may track.
Counterpart
the fact that our economic analysis of the impacts
the reports that are done for certain festivals are really good and certain others are very poor. Mm-hmm. So one way to increase the understanding of economic impact is to make sure there are better reports. Yeah. Without actually any improved in terms of number or volume. So I think we want to see a growth in vibrancy, we want to see a growth in impact, and none of that relates to what the city gets back, but it's understanding, so a better analysis might be helpful. Mm-hmm.
So we almost changed the indicator from a dollar figure to a higher reporting requirements from organizers, like event organizers, or I don't know what.
I'm not sure we can solve that one here. Mm-hmm. I mean, I think it's direction that will occur and we'll have some thoughts and bring back to it.
Well, and it's kind of to a certain extent, what is our target? And if our target is to maintain, our target is to, if we can keep it at 5 million, we're happy with that? And so, I mean, it's a little bit, and I'm okay with that because, I mean, I recognize that in a lot of economic stuff has lost, negatively 8 to 15%. Like, Seattle's down 25%. I mean, it's like, so the fact that we actually stay the same, even in the face of 1% increases elsewhere, we're probably, you know, in my view, that's pretty good if we can actually maintain a $5 million direct spending.
So we just throw that there.
So let's just put $5 million direct spending over. No allowance for inflation. Okay. Any other changes?
For that same lot, should the word festival be in there, or is entertainment kind of supporting the best? I think of the parade, I think of the Canada Day, does it become all
this? This is ticketed because it's direct spending, as opposed to the what happens around an event. So these are ticket sales, for example.
On the economic impact of the small
arts culture tank because of direct spending.
Oh, okay, sorry. Thank you. Yeah.
So we can calculate maybe with the parade how much they broke. Well, obviously, do we calculate how many rooms are rented because of it? Mm-hmm. But we don't calculate how many hot dogs are sold.
But this is actually related to tickets.
Yes.
Whatever the measurement we have, keep it the same, and we keep the measure the same.
Yeah.
Well, even better yet, to work with our partners like Tourism Victoria, who actually does their own studies. I mean, once again, for the parade, I mean, they have room rental numbers. They actually track these. The city doesn't have to. It's just not. It's just a comment that we don't have to do it ourselves when we have agencies that do. That's exactly why they're created, is to measure.
Great. Thank you. Any other changes to page 31? Seeing none. Let's go to page 32, our bright future.
I'm sorry, but being an optimist, I actually hope we would be concluding our work at 12:30, and I have to depart for another city-related function that happens at 1 o'clock, so I won't be able to join you in the rest of your conversation. But on page 32, the two comments I had is that I think it's important for us to be consistent with our language around replacing the word customer with resident. And I also think it would be useful to put some language in this as a concluding statement that reflects some of the mayor's language around the quality of life priority that we added. And it might actually be great to have it as the last message that reinforces again that amongst all of our desires to be fiscally responsible and all these other great things, that one of our bottom lines is the quality of life for our residents. So I would really like to see some language in there. And my apologies, but I have to leave.
Thank you. Any other changes to 32? Councillor Burchell?
Yeah, Councillor Alto's comments, instead of changing, so efficient being the second, the right hand side, the third paragraph, our focus is community on the, and she thought, does it? Could it not be our focus of community on customer service? Can we withdraw strength instead of changing that to resident?
I'll keep that.
I think that's what she was meaning, right? You said customer.
No, she wants a separate paragraph at the end that says, fundamentally, it's about improving
the quality. No, before that, their first comment. Okay. Right? First comment was on changing customer to resident. I think by just adding customer service captures what that paragraph is saying, instead of changing to resident.
So our folks are keen to be on customer service. Everybody okay? Looking for head nods? Not okay? Okay.
No.
I don't like the word customer at all. I really struggle with it. I have a suggestion of how it might be.
Suggestion. our focus will continue to be on providing services to our residents, and we will draw strength from the talented team, Residents, services, providing services to our residents and businesses, to be consistent. Residents, businesses, and visitors. Very good.
Okay. Anything else on the bright future?
Yeah.
We are all happy with that.
I love the picture.
Given, so we've captured all those changes. We need a formal motion to receive. I don't know if that's appropriate. Mr. Woodland, I'm looking in the rearview mirror.
He's not right there.
Oh, there he is.
I
just say thank you.
We need a motion to instruct staff to make the changes.
Thank you, Councilor Coleman. All those in favor? Opposed? Carried. Thank you. Council, I want to do a quick check on a biological break or
lunch.
Or lunch break.
I consider my lunch essential part of my biology.
Can we just get food and come back and eat here and work, like have a working lunch?
I think overall, why don't we just say come back in half an hour? You need to bring, you need half an hour, if it takes your food. Somebody lunch takes 20 minutes to get that long to get that food, bring it back. Thank you, Councilman. Do we have a prediction of how long the presentation is in discussion? I suspect we're looking another 2 or 3 hours.
Yeah.
I'm just wondering why we scheduled 2 hours.
Yeah.
I think the anticipation is that we wouldn't take 2.5 hours. But that's okay.
If it was on the agenda,
and I think since we got this in advance, we could just have questions rather than going through slide by slide of something we've already received.
I don't think it'd be 2 to 3 hours.
Okay. Thank you very much, everyone. Can we have you back here at 20 after 1?
So, we're coming back 20 after 1. So, 1:20. Okay. My question for you is that we were scheduled to do all of this in 2 hours. I did allow some leeway, but not at their level.
Let me just say that my 1 o'clock meeting, I'm blowing it off. I'm probably blowing off some other meetings.
That's it for you today. But
this is important. So the only other option would be to reschedule this for Monday or Tuesday, which I'm okay with.
Mm-hmm. Oh. It's better for me. I had a 1:30 appointment too when I saw the 2 hours.
Okay, let me do a quick check on this, folks. Everybody, let's take a quick check on this. Just looking for a hold. I got to tell you, my Monday's really good.
Monday's good.
Steph, can we do this at what you guys prefer, Monday morning at 10? Or do you guys prefer Monday at 1?
1 would be better for me.
There we go. 1 p.m.
Monday at
1. The budget discussion will be postponed until Monday at 1 p.m. It's in camera at this time. And then come back and do that then. Thank you very much for your indulgence, staff. We apologize for this. I need a motion. Motion to postpone, please.
So moved.
All those in favor? Opposed? Carried. Motion to adjourn, please.
So moved.